this morning, I set out to capture one of the last grain trains we would ever see run on the Georgia Northeastern Railroad. Well, at least the last grain train for me. At around 7:30 in the morning, I arrived at Elizabeth in Marietta, spotting the train delivered by CSX with the EOT flashing on the rear. The GNRR crews were on duty and started to get these trains moving on this gloomy Monday morning. It only took a few hours to get the grain train split up for three of the GP38 EMD engines to take them north. Was going around that the Pilgrims Pride grain elevator in Canton, Georgia, served by the Georgia Northeastern, was fixing to move locations after completion of the new grain elevator in Ranger, Georgia, off of CSX's Etowah subdivision. There was no telling when I'd see another grain train on the GNRR, with days counting down for the grand opening of the new facility. Little did I know that this would definitely be my last sighting. The 421 leads the way as they take 22 of the 44 loaded grain cars towards Canton. I'll let the trains do the talking until we get to Pilgrim's Pride. Enjoy the sounds of some classic EMD power on the old LNN mainline. Don't go anywhere. We have to take a quick break. We'll be right back. We'll be arriving here at Pilgrims Pride momentarily, as soon as we come back. We now arrive at Pilgrims Pride at 11:25, taking almost 2 hours to get here from Marietta. The 103 job crew takes off the derail and prepares to split up the train onto the grain elevator track. They split them up evenly by 11, I'd guess so they wouldn't have to block the road crossing. They come back to get the other half of the train and pull it into the grain elevator track once more, then shoving it back with the rest. Pilgrim's Pride would take over from here.
Thank you.
With their work now complete, they would come back out, engines light, where they would set back up the derail. Back towards the main line on the north side before heading back south to Elizabeth to pick up the second half of the grain train. I wait to chase them southbound, now with the 3804 at the lead, and three covered hoppers being pulled behind them that they got from Pilgrims Pride. They would be taking them all the way back to Marietta. Gotta step away for just a moment. Don't you go anywhere. We'll be right back. now on the west side of I-75, finding the 101 job on the Elizabeth Local, waiting for the 103 job to pass them on the main line, powered by Georgia Northeastern locomotive number 2000. They would be following them out onto the main line before having to work at Coca-Cola Enterprises, accessible at the Canton Road grade crossing. The 103 job working on getting the second half of the grain train, I waited around Elizabeth again right outside of the rail yard. The 101 job came in at 1353 with two tank cars from Coca-Cola Enterprises. Then, at 14:09, the 103 job was ready to head back north with the second half of the grain train. It was another busy day for the Georgia Northeastern. Timing worked out perfectly for me today, as I had to head off to work for the afternoon. If it's one thing that I'll miss, it's hearing the glorious sounds of these old GP38 engines in full power pulling these grain trains. If you enjoyed today's video, make sure you leave it a thumbs up by hitting that thumbs up button, and please subscribe to my YouTube channel if you haven't already. See y'all next time from Marietta, Georgia, at milepost 475.9 along the Georgia Northeastern Railroad.